you think of when you hear the word migration? I know what I think of. Geese. We're all aware of the waterfowl migration that passes overhead every spring and fall. Wildlife researchers have taken to the air to study this amazing phenomenon.
When you see the birds, and especially if you're flying low to get an idea of what types of birds are around, it really is a spectacle.
And let's just do one more pass real low. I want to get the species composition. Saw a fair number of mallards, but I didn't get a real good look.
You'll have birds flying by, zipping by, you know, on all sides of the plane, so you just feel like you're surrounded by ducks and geese when you're in the middle of that.
Fall waterfowl migration is one of Missouri's most spectacular natural events.
Well, here, let me
biologist Andy Radke and pilot Chet Hartley get the privilege of seeing this phenomenon from a unique aerial perspective during the Conservation Department's annual waterfowl survey.
And then we'll go on over to Swan Lake and Fountain Grove and see what's going on up that way as well.
Normally, we have a route that we fly that's pretty routine. We go in at 400 to 500 foot of altitude, and we do our aerial photos. They kind of keep a running record of that. Then after that, we drop down and we get down about somewhere around 75 to 100 feet, and we literally count the number of animals that we see, in this case, duck.
Yeah, there's really two primary purposes. The one is to really see the timing of when ducks and geese come into Missouri. We use that information for setting hunting regulations and also just knowing in general the chronology of when ducks and geese arrive. The other major reason we do the surveys is to really monitor the habitat conditions in Missouri. We even restored, you know, lots of wetlands in the last 10 or 20 years. And so we want to find out where ducks and geese are using wetlands and what types of wetlands they're using.
The information gained on the aerial survey helps to better manage Missouri's wetlands. Husband and wife duck hunting team, Eric and Renee Martin, appreciate the results.
You know, we spend a lot of time, just the two of us, in our duck boat or in a blind, or, you know, it's just one more thing that we can share together.
It's about who we are. I've grown up in the outdoors my whole life. I've, you know, learned how to fish when I was a little kid. I've been hunting since I was 11. And it's a part of my personality, and it's great when you can share it with other people in similar interests. A lot of these public hunting areas that we have now are really doing their job to hold a lot of birds while they're migrating. So I think the numbers are just gonna continue to go up. I see a bright future for ducks.
Let's go. Ooh, nice shot.
For Eric and Renee Martin, duck hunting is more than a weekend hobby. It's a lifestyle, a passion, and it's giving them a lifetime of memories. And in the skies above Missouri's wetlands, biologists are working together with skilled pilots to assess the effectiveness of these important ecosystems, essential parts of Missouri's natural heritage. In the process, they're getting a unique look at one of the things that makes Missouri special, the fall migration.